I've always had a fascination with prosthetics, some for obvious reasons since I don't have a hand. But I've never really dove into it until back in April. I met this guy named Sashi at a networking event. And he was talking amongst these people about this hand that he had that he wanted to print out, and he had a rendering of it on his phone. And so I automatically got intrigued with it. I was just kind of listening in on it, not even involved in conversation. He whips out his phone and I see the picture and I just walk up to him and ask for it. And that's essentially how it all started. And we met up a couple times. He printed out me this prototype here. Tools, it just takes a screwdriver and your patience. Also, we print all the materials with the 3D printers. A lot of it was actually printed here at the Makerspace. Just basic 3D printers. There's the two fingers that are carbon fiber. Here we did that just to like kind of test the material out. And then these two fingers here in the thumb are ABS plastic, which is the most common plastic used to build Legos. And then the gauntlet and the palm are both PLA, which is like a biodegradable corn plastic. And then yeah, everything else underneath of it is Velcro with duct tape and a mouse pad. First, when I was a kid, the basic prosthetics, they're just hooks, and they cost around $5,000, between $2,000 to $5,000 is the basic one, and you have to completely manipulate your body, so you have to like move your shoulder back, throw your elbow forward, move your elbow forward again, and it opens, something like that, just super complicated, really annoying, obnoxious to use, and plus it's a hook, so it's kind of intimidating, especially when you're a child. So with this here, it works on your natural body movement. So it works on your wrist motion. I have a little bit here. So if I can get it to work with myself, it can work with anybody that has a little bit of wrist. And since it's 3D printed, it's extremely lightweight and customizable to that person. I plan on creating a company out of it. Actually, I'm in the works of doing that now. And with that, we would provide these prosthetics. We would just have an online website and an app where the person would scan their arm, they'd submit those measurements to us. We'll print it to the scale after they design it, since 3D printed, 100% customizable. They design it to however they want it to look, pick the color, whatever it is. And then we print it out to them and ship it to them, all for around $300 instead of the $5,000 that the competitors offer. And moved down here originally because the startup scene is incredible, and I didn't have enough credits to transfer over to PSU, so into PCC for a cheaper alternative. Also, they have in-state tuition. Yeah, it was just something that I just found online. I was looking just for different colleges in Oregon, closer to like the Portland metro area. Then I found PCC, read up on it, heard it was like one of the best community colleges in the nation. So I thought it was a good fit to start out in groups. And at the Makerspace, everyone that's there, they want to create something, want to change something. So it's amazing. You walk in there and somebody's creating something new, designing something new that the world's never seen before. It's actually pretty exciting. And also all the equipment that's there, thousands of dollars worth of equipment that's just open to any student to use, like however they please, which I think is incredible. Not everyone has a 3D printer at this point, and their 3D printers are on the verge of exploding. And as soon as these students and other people can have an experience with them, they're going to be ahead of the game for when the 3D printing industry actually rises to its peak.